brings me to the interesting point that people always ask, you know, what is my susceptibility to getting the COVID-19 infection? In fact, it should be a two-part question. Acquisition of the infection is one thing, and how the individual or their body deals with the infection is the second thing. So people with compromised immune systems, older individuals, and so on, are certainly more susceptible to getting the COVID-19 infection. But unlike a lot of conventional viruses, the thought is that a lot of the damage to the body and organ problems occur because the body mounts an exuberant immune response to the virus. And it's that battle that the body gets caught in. So paradoxically, patients whose immune systems may be slightly suppressed, either because of the disease or because of the treatment they are getting, you know, maintenance therapy for myeloma, for example, may actually have a reduced risk of organ damage and life-threatening complications and so on. This is very general, you know, I mean, it's not a rule, but that's our observation based upon the data that are available. Obviously, the best way to deal with this is to take all appropriate precautions to avoid getting infected in the first place. So I think the key thing to bear in mind is that more than the underlying disease, it is the overall situation, including the treatment, that makes a very big difference to the outcome of patients.